fans of Privateer FX coming at you with a preview of the foreign exchange markets for the ECB. We've got no change in rates scheduled, and we'll be looking at reinvestment of quantitative easing sums, and we will be just looking at the tone of what Mr. Draghi has to say. As far as the charts are concerned, above 40 is quite interesting in euro now. 118.40 technically is quite interesting. You can see it's sort of a head and shoulders-y type pattern here. Shoulder here, head here, inverse head and shoulders. A lot of people are going to be watching that, but it will be messy over the announcement, so you have to use parameters that are slightly wider and maybe position sizes that are slightly smaller. Euro yen on the same token. Euro yen, we have this interesting high from yesterday at 33. Euro yen could go either way. Stocks have been mildly off for today. And if he's super hawkish, okay, knee jerk is euro yen higher. Then if equity markets get caned, then you could obviously see some risk aversion affecting euro-yen and going lower. So euro-yen's probably not the vehicle we're super interested in today. The focus will really be on euro-dollar. Let's have a look at euro-sterling just in case you have interest. Cable had better retail sales today and went up to 134.46. We're back at 30 now. I like cable higher, continuing throughout the day. And so if you like cable higher and you think he's going to be dovish, you might be on to something. Euro sterling, the point of no returns, 87.60. I don't know what to do with U.S. sterling. This top side looks vulnerable, but if you're going to be buying euros, you might as well just buy euro dollar rather than buy euro sterling today. So let's nix that idea, euro sterling. Euro Aussie's already very, very big. We don't want to chase that. It's already up 0.6%. Euro CAD. We do have this little area here in Euro CAD, 153.63. EuroCAD is hard to trade, liquidity is not as good. So again, if you have a bee in your bonnet for dollar CAD higher, as we did yesterday, but not so much today, EuroCAD might be your vehicle. It's not a bad setup here with all of these highs here. But for us, it's pretty straightforward. We'll be looking at Euro topside, 118.40. And if he's dovish, we're going to be playing euro-yen downside 129.60, so 40 points away. Always difficult these days. The micro-volatility can be quite daunting, so I encourage you all to visualize what you think is going to happen in advance and prepare yourself for micro-vol that can be slightly insane by trading slightly smaller amounts. Quickly, let's take a look at Bitcoin. I forgot to mention this. You get your Bitcoin at 6,200. Now we're on the sale side of these what we purchased. So you're basically 6,800, 7,200, 7,500. You want to sell 90% of the position. So if you bought 10 coins, you want to sell 9 of those out and leave 1 with the average well below 5,000. Because we want to prepare ourselves for the inevitable flush that is going to happen in Bitcoin when we break 5,000. Alright, not really a Bitcoin day, it's a Euro day. Good luck, people. 118.40 or 129.60. We're looking both ways, listening closely to Mr. Draghi. Take care. See you tomorrow at the New York Open.